Today we're having a look at singers' biggest bops versus their biggest flops, like August. August is here to represent flops. I'm here to represent bops.
Okay.
We got a bop. Taylor Swift's Shake It Off from 2014. This is the most parodiable song ever. You can do like, you know, whatever.
Yeah, I can think of one word.
Pooper's gonna poop. It's so easy. Shrimper's gonna shrimp. I like that. I don't think it's real brass, especially not the bottom one. It's not, but it's kind of like a nice tone.
I know what it is. It's a mellotrone, which means that it actually is brass, but it's sampled in a very specific way.
Yeah, when I say real, I mean it's not played live. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, I think.
Most things are sampled nowadays. Am I right, guys? AI is taking over very soon, and we'll all give up. And if a flop, we have the story of us. Wait, was this a flop? I like this song. Come on, that's great.
If you compare it with someone who is not as huge as Taylor Swift, of course this is not a flop.
No, because I've heard it.
Yeah. But if you look at the chart performance in relation to her other singles, it didn't do as well.
Why do you think that is?
To me, this has a little less personality than some of her other songs.
I don't think it has less personality than Shake It Off. Shake It Off is quite pop. Here we have bop, Michael Jackson's Billie Jean. I like those he vocals.
I like the video effects in the music video.
Looks like Instagram. Here we have Michael Jackson's biggest flop, Butterflies from 2001. I have not heard this. So this does feel more like a flop. And he knows it. Just look at his face. Look at him. He's like, oh, it's a flop.
Like, no, it flopped. When all I can do is
you know what I call that? I call that like hipster soul. It's that type of like musician beats where like everything like needs to be like a little bit off and you got all like collared like backing vocals, like all the jazzy backing vocals. It's the type of music that only musicians really vibe with, I feel like.
Maybe. I think this fits into the genre neo soul, right? I feel like this is a genre that's huge in the States, but maybe not necessarily so much in the rest of the world.
Here we have a bop, Backstreet Boys, Quit Playing Games With My Heart, 1996. This is my childhood, man. Impossible as it may seem, but I wish I could. Oh, it's so hard to watch this now.
Oh, yes! Oh, that look.
Brian could have been a TikTok e-boy. That jawline's crazy. Here we have their biggest flop. Show them what you're made of. Then we'll start to
new dance moves.
And no shirts. I think there's a certain burn time on boy bands, unless they really reinvent themselves.
I think that they were painted out as such, in Swedish we call it girl idols. That was their whole image. Then I think just from growing up, like they grew up, their fans grew up, and as you said, they didn't really renew themselves.
You can kind of see on Bieber, like he suddenly started catering to like a male audience way more. He started working with Skrillex and like all this stuff. Without that, I don't think he could have sustained into still being a star, you know?
If you think about One Direction too, if you take their solo careers, it's really like a big thing that the music is more mature.
For sure. Okay, here we have Harry Styles with his bop As It Was. It's just
us. Oh yeah, this is the voice that I can do.
Oh yeah, in the singing impressions video, you versus Jonas. Here we have Harry's flop, and now people are gonna be angry, August. You were the one who said this was a flop.
I own it.
We got Kiwi from 2017. I think I'm losing it. Oh, I think she said, having your baby. It's none of your business. I'm having your baby. It's none of your business. very repetitive, but like, it's fun. I wonder if that's like from his real life. Someone he had a special connection to was like, yeah, I'm having a baby and there's nothing like you can do about it. Oh man, that's crazy.
If that is from his real life, that is crazy.
I didn't mind it. I thought it was fun. It's just like a genre that's not very popular. It's kind of like that Arctic Monkeys type beat.
My take on this is that he is so inspired by 70s rock and this one is just too much exactly that, so that it almost sounds a little bit spoofy.
I kind of think it sounds like early 2000s retro-inspired rock. Part of the mistake here is that the sound isn't retro enough. Like, it sounds like a modern version of it.
That type of retro had already been done, basically.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, good call.
Here we have a bop, Pink's So What from 2008. Have you seen her live? She's amazing.
She's very technically good.
And like also the shows she does, it's like she's almost like an acrobat. And here we have a flop, Secrets from 2018. I got some things to say. Production's great. I wasn't too much of a fan of the melodies. Da, 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 da. I don't know. It was whatever. Very neatly dressed up, okay song.
I think it would have performed a lot better with a different artist.
So what are you implying here, August?
I'm implying that I think people might have a difficult time associating Pink with that type of groove. It lacks the attitude that most of her stuff has.
Yeah, I think if you start out in rock, it can be kind of hard to transition. Rock is a very dedicated audience that sticks around forever, but they're not huge. I think it's easy to feel that pressure to want to move out of the rock scene, just like, you know, Taylor Swift successfully did with country. Here we have a bop, Nickelback's Rockstar for 2005. I have other more favorites Nickelback songs, but I will accept this. Girls come easy and the come cheap. I've been there. I'll stay skinny. Just
won't eat it. Well, I've been there. No.
There was a lot of girls in bikinis in there, but not a lot of like half naked men. I wonder why that is. I'm just thinking.
Are you thinking? Don't try too hard, Joel.
Here we have a flop, Nickelback's Satellite from 2015. Dance around this bedroom like we've only got tonight. Not about to let you go till the morning light. You can be my whole world if I can be satellite. That was boring, I gotta say. It was not very fun.
I think that this sounds like a song from the 90s, but it's from 2015.
It's very cliche. The chords are like the axis of awesome chords. And I don't know. The lyrics are like, ooh, love, whatever. I don't know. Moonlight, whatever. You know, it's just like, ugh. Everything just makes me shut my brain off. By the way, if you want to meet friends in the community, we have a Discord. Discord.gg/roomie. Check it out.
We are even there sometimes.
Here we have a bop. Celine Dion, My Heart Will Go On from 1997. Back when I still believed in love. It's unfathomable how big this movie was.
I don't know if this is just my sense of humor, but if you go back where there's a choir singing, they come in right when some backing vocals come in. And it's really,
yeah,
really
I think that's on purpose.
Me.
I thought about that too, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, that's totally on purpose. Yeah. Here we have flop, Celine Dion, Be the Man on this night, 1997. So I'm in the camp that thinks that Celine Dion should just be on the charts all the time. She seems like an amazing person. Her voice is angelic. Anyway. Be the man that's mine. Find the love that never goes away. Boring. I'm sorry, this sucks. It's not her fault. The flop one just wasn't good. It also wasn't attached to like a billion-dollar movie.
That's a fair point.
Here we got Drake's One Dance from 2016, and it's a bop. I pray to make it back in one piece. I pray. That's why I need a one dance. Got a Hennessy in my hand. One more time before I go. Higher powers taking a hold on me. I need a one dance. I find his pronunciation quite addictive. One more time before I go. Higher powers taking a hold on me. I like One Dance. I think it's a sick minimal song. Drake gets a lot of flack. Not entirely without reason, for sure. But he's done some good music. And here we have Drake's flop, Preach, from 2015. You know what's going on, you know what's going on. She keep it wet, less than I. She thinks she saw the Titanic. I get a holla with wasabi. She think it's Willie and Oz. I think I'm a pop one for you. Drink one for you. Young Preach. So the difference between these two songs for me is that One Dance has like a relatively unique track, even though it's minimal and like really like kind of melodies and lyrics that stick out a little bit. This has a generic track. There's nothing that stands out about it to me. It's good though. Could definitely vibe to it.
What I find interesting is that this was the first single off of that mixtape that it came from.
Oh, I wonder if it's one of those things where like Drake decided just like didn't listen to the label and just like, this is the first single. I'm Drake now. I didn't used to be Drake, but I am now.
The label is called Cash Money.
Sadly, that flop didn't bring in that much cash money, am I right, guys? Here we have Bop, Rihanna, We Found Love, featuring Calvin Harris from 2011. Wow, that feels like yesterday. I am old. This song used to always come up in songwriting school because it's the same melodies over and over. Yellow diamonds in the light. And then it's like, we found love in a hopeless place. So it's literally the same melodies over and over. So it's like, ooh, it's so genius. We're all sitting, ha ha.
And also like similar production throughout most of it too.
Here we have Rihanna. Oh, they did a cover of Raining Men?
It's not a cover. It's their own song.
Oh no. Sounds like Train wrote it.
Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa.
I thought it was a vibe, but there's nothing to remember from that song. I'm just like, this is nothing going on. Here we have a bop, Lady Gaga and Bradley Cooper, Shallow, for 2018. I'm not a fan of this song. I'm going to come clean and say that. I think this is...
Me neither.
It's in a great registry for her. She sounds great.
So does he.
I don't like the shalalalalo stuff. It's pretty, it's fine. It's not as good as My Heart Will Go On, of course. And here we have Dance in the Dark, a flop from 2009. It's not very good. I'm trying to think of redeeming qualities for this. Like, it's just very generic. It sounds like a Eurovision Song Contest thing.
It sounds like another song. Which song?
Every song.
Okay.
Click here for a video where we compare artists most streamed versus least streamed songs. And we'll see you in the next one. August, tell us your deepest secret about your body.
It's not solid.
Yeah, some Viagra could help with that. Ka-ching!